you. Hi, guys. I'm Michał. And since I'll be talking on ADHD today, well, I didn't manage to prepare the presentation. And it's not because I'm lazy or stupid or I'm a bad public speaker. I actually love creating. I love giving value to the audience. But I was physically not able, even though for the last 3 months I have this constant drill in my head saying, dude, you have to start writing. I just couldn't do it physically. Do you feel overwhelmed a little bit right now? Well, imagine how I feel on the stage. This is the feeling of ADHD. ADHD is having the ability to be the best in the world, but failing to deliver. And saying the best in the world, I mean it. Top scientists, artists, and businessmen have this condition, but at the same time, a lot of prisoners have it too. It's often very little that makes a world champion, or a criminal, a billionaire, or a drug addict. So today I'd like to show you some tools which can turn this flaw into a superpower. But wait, why is this important? I mean, you probably think, I don't have ADHD, and there's only like 5% people that have it, right? Well, actually, among entrepreneurs, it's more like 30%. So if you don't have it, and the person to the right doesn't, look to the left, because statistically that person is struggling just like me. And you might ask, what's the struggle about? Well, did you know that cardiovascular diseases reduce your life expectancy by 2 years? Smoking does so by 6. Whereas if you have ADHD, it means that statistically you will live shorter 13 years. And that number goes up if you're undiagnosed and untreated. Pretty fucking important to me. But wait, isn't ADHD something that we call ourselves when we're lazy and forgetful? Well, I wouldn't believe myself either if I were you, because from time to time, we all get those symptoms. For example, I can't remember people's name if my life depended on it. My best friend's daughter is 3 years old already, and I can't remember if it's Grażyna or Gabrysia. And I have to keep referring to her as the little one. And I really hope that he doesn't watch this because he doesn't know. We're hyperactive, as you can see. Always behind schedule, cannot hold still. I'm really shitty in handling rejection. Get this, my girlfriend is one of the best public speakers in our country. When I ask her for advice on my presentation, she has the best feedback ever. And me, instead of being thankful for her that she delivered what I asked her, I'm pissed off because she didn't say, I'm awesome. On top of that, we can't focus, we're basically bipolar, and when somebody says no to us, we are furious. We can't listen and ask way too many questions. We lose everything and can't organize at all. In short, we're fucking annoying. But the problem is that every one of us has these things from time to time. But with ADHD, it's all of those things all the time. How is it possible? Well, due to recent functional MRI research, we see why it's happening. In a normal brain, and information goes from prefrontal cortex, which is responsible for thinking and problem solving, into caudate, which controls emotions and impulsivity, back in the loop. So when a normal person makes a slide, they do the slide, prefrontal cortex, evaluate it, and then go to the next slide to prepare the whole presentation, and it goes on and on in a loop. Simple, right? Where it's not neurodiverse, and people, nothing is simple. The whole loop short circuits, so it's chaos. An ADHD entrepreneur would be doing a slide, and halfway through, she'd think of profit and loss analysis, and then an investor pitch she's supposed to do next week, and then continue to think about distribution of a new product. Then she'd remember a tax was due a couple of days back, and then some HR issue, and all at the same time. Obviously, we're not able to focus and finish a task. And we're chasing these things all the time in our head and constantly having this buzz. It's very tiring. You guys probably think, okay, Michał, you're overwhelmed when a couple of things fall on your head at the same time. We all are, right? Well, with ADHD, it's quite the opposite. We're amazing when shit hits the fan. When everybody panics and things have to be done ASAP, we thrive. It's when the things are calm, our brain doesn't get enough dopamine, so it jumps from one thing to another in search for stimuli. That is why I would do so well as a CEO of a rapidly growing company, but not so much as an accountant. And it's all because on a chemical level, our brains do not produce a sufficient amount of this really important neurotransmitter, a thing that is responsible for concentration and awards, dopamine. We don't have it as much as normal people, and there's constant need of changing the way things are. This uneasiness goes with us throughout our entire life. And this is why we can achieve so much, but are very rarely satisfied. You might say it's good, because it imagine, but on the other hand, imagine that you're winning a gold medal in Olympics and be like, eh. That's why Michael Phelps has 28 of them. You think he's still satisfied? And it's all good when we have sports or music to scratch this dopamine itch. But it's bad when you do it with drugs such as alcohol. And we love alcohol. Alcohol is a depressant, which means it relaxes our nervous system and stops the chaos in our head for a while. But in result, we are prone 10 times more to be addicted than the next person. And this is why it's absolutely crucial that we find work which is hard enough so we don't get bored, and not too hard so we don't get discouraged. It's tough, but once you hit this jackpot, boy oh boy, you are in something called hyperfocus. Activities that excite us are like cocaine to our brain. We can go 16 hours without sleeping or peeing or eating. The whole world could be non-existent to us. But there's only one problem. We don't get to choose what excites us. Our brain does so in the most random way. Fortunately, ADHD is a truly astonishing condition. When every flaw has an upside, which might make a great career. For example, thinking abstract thoughts can lead to great scientific discoveries, such as the theory of relativity. If you have too much energy, you'll make a great athlete and win 4 Olympics in a row. If you get stuck on things, it might mean you're making your product too good, but once they're out on the market, they might be the next iPhone. If you cannot hold still, it's good, because you have to fail many times until you build IKEA store chain. And when it comes to being sensitive, we often think how to help everyone around us. And if you do it on scale, it might have a positive impact on many lives. And we often dwell on the negatives. But once you see all the problems, you might become one of the strongest leaders solving them, like the president of your country. A good one. And of course, nobody wants a crybaby. But imagine if you express this fragility artistically, then you can become the dreamer that touches millions. And if someone says no and you disagree with them, it can be tricky, because you might not make some friends, but you will make a real change as an activist. Our constant interrupting with the most out-of-the-box questions can make a pain-in-the-ass student, but a great investor. And when it comes to losing stuff, I like to think that I'm giving them away to a stranger in need. Now you can see why proper management of this condition is so crucial. With the right tools, therapy, and medication, it can transform into a true superpower. Unfortunately, I didn't know I had ADHD until 3 years ago. But damn it, they were symptoms. I was so hyperactive as a kid, I ended up in the hospital every other week. I was always in trouble. I kept my grades straight, so I was off the hook. Because thanks to nearly photographic memory, which is often a trait with neurodiverse people, everything came super easy to me. I managed to get into the best university in the country, and you would figure I took it seriously. Well, with nobody watching over me, I partied all the way through it. And even then, I managed to land jobs in banking and consulting, a dream to many of my colleagues. So I suit up for work and suit up for the altar. And it was fun for a while, until it wasn't. I needed more stimulation. So when I was 26 years old, and I still didn't know I had ADHD, but I read somewhere that if you do something you love, you won't work another day in your life. So out of my love for cooking, I started a first Polish international cooking school. which quickly became the number one thing on TripAdvisor. But again, I didn't have enough stimuli. So I used a startup methodology to develop B2B products, and it was the bomb. It kept me busy for a couple of years. My company grew, earned me a ton of money and fame in Taiwan, out of all places. But then again, calm and safe time came. I became a dad, so I took paternity leave to take care of my boy with my wife. And I got depressed. imagine how pissed my wife was, because you know, we ADHD people like to steal the thunder, but I was having a better postpartum depression than her. That is simply a dick move. So I was depressed because I had no stimulation from work. But like with every situation in ADHD, this too had an upside. While holding my baby, I figured out this kid will have shitty future if we don't take care of the food system, which is damaged, because the way we produce food now damages our health and our planet. So I started a top food tech startup accelerator in Central Eastern Europe, and I was working with the most inspiring founders in the sustainability business. Literally the coolest job on the planet, and it gave me so much pleasure. I mean, who doesn't like to be a know-it-all? But guess what? My second kid came, and I lowered my guard again. At this point, I was spending half a year working from Thailand, Italy, Tenerife, you name it. Great life, huh? Well, I got bored again, and I know a lot of you might think at this point that I am nuts. Well, hold my beer. I had everything society told me to achieve in my entire life and more by the time I was 33. However, I still felt there's something is missing, you know, this feeling of uneasiness and anxiety. Therefore, I figured out my marriage makes me this way. So I divorced this smart, loving, caring girl who gave me two beautiful and smart children, an amazing life, just because she wasn't exciting enough for me. And I went on a dopamine adrenaline binge with parties and extreme sports, and I got even more depressed. So at this point, I'm thinking, there must be something really wrong with me. Why can't I stay satisfied for a minute? I mean, at least these things should give me satisfaction, right? In my first company, hosted over 100,000 clients in culinary events. I own 1 to 10% stake in 35 companies which I helped build. Total market of these companies went from $0 to $25 million in just 5 years. And every day I meet the most exciting people out there. Here included. In the meantime, I'm raising two kids. I learn how to play guitar, wakeboard, kitesurf, fight Muay Thai, dance. I've traveled the world, and so I should enjoy every second of my life. But still, I was bored and depressed, and it was crushing me. ADHD was ruining my life, and I still didn't know I have it. Fortunately, one of my friends told me, dude, you have to get diagnosed. And this diagnosis saved my life. I was carrying this. The moment I understood I'm not crazy, I just have different chemistry in my brain, I was so relieved. Imagine, I was carrying this huge rock on my back for 3 decades, and every day it was crushing me more and more. And finally, I was able to put it down. I was so relieved, I cried for a day. I get goosebumps every time I talk about this because it's so emotional for me. But the diagnosis, I finally felt relieved and calm. For the first time in my life, I was actually calm. But the diagnosis is just step one. The real superpower comes when you truly know yourself, work hard, and build on your strengths. Authors of modern day Bible on the subject, ADHD 2.0, like to call this condition a Ferrari brain with bicycle brakes. Once you work on those brakes, you're in God mode. So for those of you who think you might have ADHD, first and foremost, go to a psychiatrist. You do medical regular checkups, right? Have you ever done a mental one? I know it's scary because it carries a stigma. I was afraid. But then I asked myself, do I really want to listen to people who don't care about me and, first of all, don't believe in science? Nah. Plus, they have cool meds. What do you think will calm you down if you're hyperactive? Amphetamine. People often get scared because, you know, it's a drug. It's a street drug. Well, don't be. The drug is served to the kids, so it's very safe, and you cannot get addicted. Actually, what it does, it's 60% of the times, it helps you to get rid of the addiction because you don't have to self-medicate yourself anymore with alcohol, for example. It appears that stimulants in low doses calm ADHD people down because they allow us to gather more dopamine, so we don't have to chase it anymore. When taken regularly, we operate like normal normative people, which leads to more confidence, less depression, and anxiety. If you want to outsmart your brain, it is crucial to start doing things quick and sloppy. Moving fast and breaking things is also a great strategy in life. My friends laugh at me because I would start 35 things and maybe end up doing 5 of them. I constantly test everything in my life. Well, the joke's on them, because out of 35 of my portfolio companies, 20 are still growing. And if I end up exiting only from 5 of them successfully, I would be more than happy. And so can you. Simply put your creative superpowers to use. Start a business and make sure you pair up with someone who feels great at delivering what you have invented. In every business, I have an operational mastermind, or as a partner or a key employee. But to make room for creative thinking, we have to get rid of the mundane tasks which eat up your time. We often get stuck on things like cleaning or taxes. Even in my top game, I cannot do these things, and it would take a professional five times less time than me. And I know what you're thinking. We cannot afford to delegate tasks, to pay someone to do our stuff. But all I'm asking is try. You'll pay $100 for a couple of hours of virtual assistant, and then you'll know. Every person I recommended this is using an assistant, at least a couple of hours a month. Pay someone to delegate those tasks and create additional revenue streams, or simply rest. Because rest is the most important thing if you want to keep in balance. Various studies have shown that if we sleep less than 7 hours a day, you get sick in the long run. Speaking of running, you need a fuel to run that Ferrari engine of yours. Due to recent research, ADHD brain operate better on omega acids, fresh greens, high protein, and whole grain products, and cut down the alcohol to zero, like a monk. And if you have to do it, especially at a place like this one, don't exceed more than 3 drinks a night, 2 times a week tops. Speaking of Buddhist monks, they are the happiest group of people alive for a reason. They are doing mindful meditation. Research has shown that it supports both therapy and medication in calming our minds. And once your body is healthy and your head is clear, you have mind calm enough so you can find that passion of yours. Doesn't matter if you make it for fun or if you make it a business, staying in hyper-focus is the best feeling there is. If nonetheless you have to do hard things and productive and boring stuff, do it early in the morning when your dopamine levels are still high. Leave playing PlayStation for later in the afternoon. And don't even think about touching your phone for the first hour or two. There are many great things you can do instead, like meditating, eating good, doing sports. There's one other thing you can do to get your focus, working out daily, especially with exercises that require balance. Cerebellum in our brain is impaired with people with ADHD, which means that fighting sports or boarding sports are a really good thing for us. But even if you're tough outside, remember, kindness and openness heal our brain. We learn and work way better when we're surrounded with people, especially with the ones we know and like. I know it sounds like a cliche, but to many of my ADHD friends, it's a novelty. Best advice here is to smile to everyone and set up regular coffees with your friends or just simply people that inspire you. Worst case scenario, you will end up with a great network of people. And if it's not you, or the person to the right, or to the left that has ADHD, or any other of your friends, offer them acceptance. It means a world to us when someone says, Michał, doesn't matter that you're late. I know you didn't do it on purpose. And especially, look out to women. I'm not trying to be sexist here, but they rarely have the hyperactive component in their ADHD, which means that they are diagnosed less often than men, so they suffer silently. And last, but absolutely not least, get diagnosed. It's crucial. If you have to remember one thing, and one thing only from this presentation, I would like you to ask to put your phone out right now, scan this code, and do the test yourself. Send it to your friends, or employees, or colleagues at work, someone in your family. It will take you half an hour, but it can significantly improve your life and maybe save the life of someone you love. If you guys want to ask any question about this, you can find me on LinkedIn. I'll be happy to help. Thank you very much for your attention and for your time.